Okay, there are track cars and then there are track cars. And today we've got the McLaren P1 GTR, £1.98 million and 986 brake horsepower with about 1,000 newton meters of torque from the hybrid powertrain. So it's a serious car, and for that we've got Martin Brundle, a former Formula One driver with McLaren, of course, to take it around the track for us. So, Martin, can you tell us a little bit about the car?
The thing that struck me immediately was just it sorted out. Everything, all it just functioned, and that's nice, because then you can just move your concentration outside of the car, and then you've got great visibility as well, which gives you immediate confidence out on the track. I really enjoyed it. It's got a huge amount of torque, so you need to respect the low pedal, because especially with a few bumps and some damp patches around, it could get pretty lively. We did some work with that traction control on, and yeah, you need to be ready for that.
Yeah. Is it, because it is a fearsome amount of power, not a very heavy car either, is it easy to get to grips with? Is it a car that holds your hand as you kind of access its performance, or is it a scary thing?
No, it's not scary at all, really. I mean, I think you could, you know, obviously I've got a lot of experience in different cars and on tracks that you don't know, and you leave a margin, and you need to understand, because you can look very silly very quickly at a place like this whereas a lot of little foibles and bumps and slippery bits and that. So, no, I very quickly became confident in it, on wets and slicks, actually. Okay. So, it's a little bit of power understeer and understeer on slicks, which I suspect is the default, how it's set up.
Yeah.
There's a bit of protection in there. If you were racing it, you'd want to dial that out.
Yeah.
Just a prodigious amount of torque.
Yeah.
You don't look for your pleasures by revving it out. There's nothing up there to thrill you.
Okay.
It's all about just the thrust of the thing and just the way it builds speed. I mean, down that little short back straight, it's all just over 270 kilometers per hour before it hit the brakes. And I think if you, on a fully dry day and you got to know it, you'd be knocking on 290, I reckon, down there. Hybrids impressed me. The F1 engine I drove recently in the Force India really impressed me.
Yeah.
Because you've got the best of both worlds. You don't quite get that satisfaction of revving out and the big revs. That's missing. But I love the way that it fills in all the torque, all the gaps in the torque and the throttle response. And it just gives you this sort of linear push that's always there and sort of dependent. Then you can start leaning on it a little bit. So the concept of a bit of that and a bit of internal combustion engine with plenty of grunt and some range at the same time appeals to me. Yeah, I imagine my next car might well be a hybrid. I like the combination. Obviously, the downside is the weight and complexity, but you can imagine Gen 2, Gen 3 of all of this lot.
Yeah.
I guess some of those are out already, but down the road, I can see how it works.
So just to sum up, because we've got this in our countdown of British cars to drive before you die, can you just sum up the experience of the P1 GTR on track in a few words?
It's a together car, and it does everything you want it to do, and it works with you, not against you. And then it just takes off like a scalded cat. It's like walk speed. I'd like to hear it from the outside, actually.
Yeah.
From the inside, it does sound a bit like a spaceship.